It's no secret that there are some trees on our planet that are almost unbelievably and inexplicably large. But which are the biggest of the big? Here, we'll delve into which trees and which families of trees hold the great distinction of being among the most massive trees to ever have lived, and which are the largest living today. These things are mesmerizing and perplexing all in one. This is nature at its most massive and beautiful. This is Biggest Trees in the World. Eucalyptus delegatensis. This fairly large sucker is a temperate or subalpine tree found in southeastern Australia and commonly goes by the names woolly butt, gum-topped stringy bark, white top, and alpine ash. Under suitable conditions, these trees can reach over 90 meters tall. However, the tallest known as of right now is found in Tasmania and has a massive height of 87.9 meters tall. They are the 10th tallest tree species on the planet and is the second tallest eucalypt, falling short only to Eucalyptus regnans. Down near the base of the tree, they are fibrous, thick, and woolly but smooth on the smaller limbs and can grow to be roughly 10,100 cubic feet in volume. They require lots of rainfall, at least by Australian standards, with 47 inches of rain per year needed to sustain the delegatensis, as well as snow and frost in the winter months. It's a big tree, but it's far from the biggest, so let's move on. Eucalyptus obliqua. This big guy is also commonly called the stringy bark, messmate, brown top stringy bark, messmate stringy bark, and Tasmanian oak. It's native to the southeastern portion of Australia and is a hardwood tree that grows to be pretty darn big. They're thought to be able to reach up to 90 meters tall, much like the delegatensis, though others have grown taller than that, but on rare occasions. The tallest right now only stands at 86 meters tall and is, also like the delegatensis, found in Tasmania. However, the tallest of the species documented were 98.8 meters or 324 feet tall. This species of eucalyptus was actually the first to be found and published by Europeans. It was discovered in 1777 during James Cook's third expedition when it was collected from Bruny Island by David Nelson, a botanist. It's considered to be one of the most important Australian hardwoods because it's easily worked and is commonly used in the building of houses, furniture, and flooring. Picea sicensis. This giant coniferous evergreen grows to roughly 100 meters or 330 feet tall, with a 5 meter or 16 foot trunk diameter. It's most commonly called the Sitka spruce and is the largest in the spruce family by far, and, for conifers, it comes in at the 5th largest and 3rd tallest. It's very prevalent in places like southeast Alaska, the whole western coast of Canada, through Washington, and into northern Oregon. When these trees get old, they typically don't have any branches below the 30 or 40 meter mark. That equates between 98 to 131 feet, which makes them not very great for climbing, and they have stiff, sharp leaves that are comparable to needles, so we wouldn't even try it. The largest in the world, the Queet spruce, is found in Olympic National Park in Washington and measures 75.6 meters or 248 feet tall, 4.55 meters or 14.9 feet in diameter, and has a cubic volume of 11,900 cubic feet. These trees usually live over 700 years, meaning they're a long-living species, but large size doesn't always mean exceptional age. It's typically used for producing paper and for timber, and is highly valued because it can grow in places with even poor soil conditions. Coast Douglas fir. This big old tree is also called the Oregon pine, the Douglas spruce, and its scientific name is too hard to pronounce, so we'll let you look that up for yourself. It's native to the western portion of North America and ranges from about mid-California up through much of Oregon and Washington and into British Columbia. It's mostly found between the west side of the Cascades all the way up to the coast and the Pacific Ocean, thus the name. It is officially the 3rd tallest tree in the world and the 2nd tallest conifer, only behind the coast redwood. They typically stand 60 to 75 meters or 197 to 246 feet tall, but they've been recorded at growing to heights up to 120 meters or 390 feet. The tallest Coast Douglas fir still alive today is 99.76 meters or 327 feet 4 inches tall and is called the Dorner fir. It can be found in Oregon in Coos County at East Fork Brummett Creek. They often grow to be around 349 cubic meters or 11,900 cubic feet and typically live between 500 and 1,000 years. So us humans should show some respect because they're older than our grandparents' grandparents. Crazy, isn't it? Tasmanian blue gum. This here big old tree is one of the most cultivated trees that comes from its native land of Australia, and it's used for all sorts of different things. The leaves are used as a herbal tea and are perfect for making essential oils, as the blue gum is the primary source of eucalyptus for eucalyptus production globally. The flowers hold pollen that is perfect for bees and the creation of honey, and the timber is used in some construction and is mainly used for pulpwood. It too has multiple names, including blue gum, southern blue gum, and its scientific name, Eucalyptus globulus. Normally, they stand around 30 to 55 meters, or 98 to 180 feet tall. There are claims that there was once a blue gum that reached 101 meters, or 331 feet in height. However, the current living record holder measures 90.7 meters, or 298 feet. Overall, they reach a volume of around 368 cubic meters, or for Americans, 13,800 cubic feet. As we said, the tree is native to Australia, but it has been planted in many other parts of the world, such as California, Hawaii, New Zealand, and Africa, because of its adaptability, growth rate, and uses. Eucalyptus regnans. Victoria in southeastern Australia, or Tasmania, is where you're going to find this next eucalyptus on our list. If you don't recognize the name, maybe you'll recognize some of its other names: swamp gum, stringy gum, Tasmanian oak, or mountain ash. It's obviously one of the tallest trees in the world, hence why it's on here with some of these other big boys, and it's the tallest flowering plant on planet Earth. Forests that are dominated by mature eucalyptus regnans have been proven to be more carbon dense than any other known forest in the world, and a forest located in the Oceanusi River catchment contained 1,867 tons of carbon per hectare, or 2.47 acres. That's a lot of carbon. The trees themselves grow to around 85 meters, or 279 feet tall, and to about 391 cubic meters, or 13,800 cubic feet in volume. However, the tallest living regnans at the moment shoots 99.82 meters, or 327.5 feet into the sky. Western red cedar. This next giant tree hails from North America and is a member of the cypress family known as Cupressaceae, and it too goes by many names. Pacific red cedar, giant cedar, shinglewood, and western or giant arborvitae are all common aliases of this tree, as well as its scientific name, Thigiplicata. It's mostly found throughout the Pacific Northwest and is commonly associated with the western hemlock and Douglas fir in the places that it grows. It is shade tolerant, meaning it can grow well in areas of dense shade, and partially because of this tolerance, it has become very popular and has been introduced to places all over the world. It's classified as a large to very large tree and stands between 65 to 70 meters, or 213 to 230 feet tall, and has a volume of up to 449 cubic meters, or 15,900 cubic feet. Kauri. This big, beautiful, coniferous tree is part of the genus Agathis, and it typically goes by its Maori name of kauri, but scientifically, it's known as Agathis australis. It's located in New Zealand and its northern districts of North Ireland. It is not the tallest tree in all of New Zealand, but by volume, it's most definitely the biggest, and that's what counts here. It grows to be up to 516 cubic meters, or 18,200 cubic feet, making it the third biggest tree by volume on this list. Forests made up of kauri trees are among some of the oldest forests in the world, and some of the antecedents of modern kauris even date way back to the Jurassic period, some 135 to 190 million years ago. The kauri is also different than a lot of other trees because of a defense mechanism it has for not allowing parasites to overtake it. The bark of kauri sheds consistently and piles up on the base of the trees, sometimes stacking to a height of 2 meters, or 6.5 feet. As we mentioned, they're not super tall and only grow to be up to 50 meters, or 164 feet tall. But their immense girth definitely makes their height not matter much. Coast redwood. This famous tree is also known as the coastal redwood, California redwood, and scientifically as Sequoia sempervirens. Now, you may know the name redwood because they're known to be some of the biggest trees in the world, and that's no lie. The species includes the tallest living trees on the planet, and speaking of living, these bad boys do that for a long, long time. Between 1200 and 1800 years is their typical lifespan, which also makes them some of the longest living things that we know of. They're found along the coast in much of California, and in the southwestern coastal areas of Oregon. Redwoods stand around 115.5 meters, or 379 feet tall, not including their immense roots, and come in at around 1,084.5 cubic meters, or 38,300 cubic feet, in volume. They're absolutely gigantic. All of the trees on this list thus far have been huge, but they're no match for the number one biggest of the big trees. But first, what was your favorite on this list so far? We'd love to hear your opinion on the best of the big trees down in the comments below. giant sequoia. Here they are, the biggest trees in all the land. Sequoias, aka giant sequoia, Sierra redwood, Wellingtonia, giant redwood, big tree, or scientifically, Sequoia dendron giganteum. These trees are absolutely humongous, and it's almost hard to wrap your head around just how large they really are. They are officially the planet's single largest trees, but they are not the tallest, with a height that falls between 50 to 85 meters, or 164 to 278.8 feet. But by volume, they are the biggest, and General Sherman, a tree you may have heard of, is the most massive tree that is still living in the world today, with a volume of 1,487 cubic meters, or 52,500 cubic feet. So big, it's hard to wrap your mind around, and forget about ever trying to do so with your hands. Well, that's it for this list. If you dug it, go ahead and click the like button below. Also, make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any of our excellent daily content, and check out this video that we picked out especially for you. Until next time.